What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're going to be talking about reinforced concrete structures. More specifically, I'm going to be showing you how to add reinforcement to a column and the foundation of that column and how to connect everything together and all of the steps that you have to take to complete a task such as that. Now, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description and then also up in the cards above. There I have many courses. For example, one of the latest courses that I have released is the reinforced concrete structures in Revit, something similar to what we're doing today. So if you want to check that out, it's a long course where I go kind of slowly step by step and explain pretty much everything that there is to know about concrete structures and reinforcement inside of Revit. Also there, of course, you can find many other courses. We have also templates, and one of the templates that is also related to this, and a template that we're going to be using in a few minutes now, and that's the reinforced concrete structures template. So it's a template that's specifically prepared for reinforced concrete structures, and it has everything kind of ready to go, so you can just come in and start creating your structures. No need to set anything up. And then also we have some really high quality Revit families, and there's a plugin as well. Okay, so now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here I have kind of prepared what we have here. You can notice that perhaps from the different project browser organization, here we are using the reinforced concrete template. So I'm just going to be using that because it already has everything loaded in, so you don't have to think about it. You do have like a default Revit template that comes with Revit for structure, and that should have most of the things that we're going to be using, or pretty much everything that we're going to be showing in this particular video. So if you want to follow along and you don't have this template, just use that one. So I think it's available here. When you go to new project, it should be there. Probably the construction default one. Yeah, and I'm using this one, the Balkan Architect Concrete and Reinforcement. Okay, so now let's get started. Here you'll see I have a floor plan, and then also I have a couple of sections that I want to use for this structure. Now first let's lay out, kind of place the concrete elements, the column and the foundation, and then we're going to be adding reinforcement, obviously. So let's go to the structure tab, then I'm going to go here to the column tool, CL is the shortcut, and then let's see, well, let's use like a, well, we can use the 45. Or a 30 by 45 millimeter column. Change this to height, and then we can connect it to level 2. Okay, and then I can just come in here, click to place it, and we're done. Hit the escape key a couple of times, and now we have our column. To add the foundation, let's go to isolated foundation. I'm going to be using this one, the smaller one, and then I can just come in here and just place it. Click to place, hit the escape key a couple of times, and there we go. We're done. We have the we have the foundation as well. We can also go to the 3D view just to kind of check it out, what we have here. There we go. Looks perfect. And now we can start adding reinforcement. So for reinforcement, you're going to be using the reinforcement panel that we have here. And usually it's best to start with the cover settings. So I'm just going to change this to thin lines so we can see everything a little bit better, or alternatively you can just change the scale if you want. So anyways, I'm just going to go here to cover, and then we can come in here, select this, and we can then see which cover we want to use, which rebar cover. And then I can say, okay, perhaps I want a 25 millimeter rebar cover, so I can just set that, hit the escape key a couple of times, and there we go. So now we have that set. You will also notice that here in the properties of that particular column, the rebar cover settings have changed. Also, you can change them here directly, so you don't have to use the rebar cover tool. You can just come in here and then you can just change it there. So you have those two approaches. Anyways, let's now move into actual rebar and placing it. So I'm just going to go here to the structural rebar tool, click OK here, and then it's going to lay out all of the rebar shapes here. So I'm just going to go all the way down, and I want to create the cage first. So let's go down, I think it's shape 51, if I'm not mistaken. There we go. Click there, and then what you want to do is you want to change this to, let's go to far cover, and then make sure that it says parallel to work plane. And now when I come in here, as you can see, I can place it here, I can place it on the foundation. Obviously, I want to have it on the column. And then you, where you see this overlap, you can just kind of go around in order to kind of place it at the correct place where you want it. I don't really care, so I'm just going to place it like this. Hit the escape key a couple of times, and then we want to select this rebar and change the layout from single to maximum spacing, and then I want to use maximum spacing of 300 millimeters. So I'm just going to add that, hit enter, and now we have kind of a correct layout. If I switch to one of the sections that we have here, you will see that now this is at the maximum distance of 300 millimeters. Okay, moving back to our column floor plan, what I'm going to do next is again go to rebar, and then let's just use like a regular bar. So I think this is on top. Yeah, we can use this shape here. And then let's change this to parallel to cover. And what we have set here, the layout, we have changed that in the for the cage, we have changed that afterwards, but you can actually change it in advance. And I like to do that when I add these regular bars, so I can go here to fixed number, and then I can say 3, and then I can place 3 like this. So I just want to place 3 of them here, and then 3 of them on the other side, just like so. Hit the escape key a couple of times. So there we go. Now, actually I want to select this rebar and change it from 10 to perhaps 8. And then this rebar here, or these two sets, I'm just going to hold the control key to select those and change these to 12. Okay, perfect. Okay, so once we have all of this in place, we can go to the 3D view, and then to visualize it in the 3D view, what you want to do is just make a cross selection, go to filter, and then just make sure to only check structural rebar. Hit apply, okay. And then in the properties panel, you will have the option to set view visibility states. So if you go here to edit, you can just check on view as solid as well as view unobscured. Click okay, and then let's change this to fine. And now you will see that rebar in 3D, just like this. Then we can go to the section. Okay, so I can come in here and I can actually extend this rebar to go down towards the foundation, because we obviously wanted to connect to the foundation. And then we're also going to be connecting it with some just some L-shaped rebar, just to kind of anchor it down even better. Okay, now let's add the reinforcement for the foundation itself. So for that, again, I can go to rebar. Then let's use like a U shape, so that's shape 21 here. Then I can come here. Okay, I have to change the work plane orientation just like that. Okay, so I can just place it here. Hit the escape key a few times. Then we can go to the other section. And then I can just come in here and just do the same thing. So rebar, same shape. And then I should be able to place it just like that. There we go. Hit the escape key a few times. And now I can select these two rebar bars. So just hold the control key. I go to 3D, and then here just change the visibility states, so just check on those options, and now we'll be able to see it here as well. Now what I like to do is just while I have them selected, I'm just going to change the layout to maximum spacing, and then let's go to, I don't know, like 200 millimeters, let's say. Now you can adjust this further by going to the sections, and then you might say, okay, I don't, obviously we can't have this overlap, so I can select this thing and move it up a little bit using these drag grips, just like so. And then obviously here, let's see, we need to move this a little bit towards the inside. There we go. So we can kind of play around with those, or we can have that this here and then going off all the way to this side. Let's see, can we do that? Okay, so it's kind of reacting to that one. Okay, so let's just leave it as is, like so. So there we go. So we have this cage kind of now in check. And then let's connect everything by some L-shaped reinforcement. So let's go to section 1. And then let's go to Rebar, but instead of picking out a shape here, I want to show you a different approach. So if you want to create a shape that perhaps isn't offered here, you can always go to Sketch Rebar. You just want to highlight the element, and in this case, I want to sketch it in the column itself. And then it's also going to show us the rebar cover, which is cool. And then we can just come in here, and let's say I want to have that L shape come in like this, and then kind of go off at the bottom, go off to the side to kind of anchor it down. And then here we can perhaps extend it a little bit further, like so, perhaps even more if we wanted to. So anyways, so we can have this kind of anchor there. Perhaps it's a bit too much. Okay, hit finish. And then also we can select it and change the layout from single to fixed number. And I'm just going to leave it at 3 because I know that these are at 3. So now if I go to the 3D view, obviously we cannot see these. So let's go back actually to the section, select it in the section, go back to the 3D view, and then again we can change the view visibility states. Okay. Perfect. So as you can see here, it's actually matching these because we have 3 of them on each side. And then I can just select this, go back to my section, and then I can use the mirror tool. MM is the shortcut, and then just use the grid line to mirror it to the other side. And now this is all connected. So as you can see, you can really quickly complete something like this. So just to show you one more trick that I really like to use, well, it's necessary in a lot of cases, it's not something that you do because you like it, but that is, sometimes you might want to add a bit more of this, these stirrups or this cage to have it a little bit closer together on the bottom where we have the connection with the foundation, and then it can be like a 300 millimeters on top. So you can actually do that in the section itself. So you can come into the section, let's expand it a little bit. Let's see, where's that? Okay, it's really difficult to select this little button there. There we go. Okay, so I can bring this up a little bit, perfect. And then the section, I can stretch that out. Okay, so now I can select these stirrups like so, and I can bring them down to go perhaps up to here, like that. And then I can just go to copy, and then I'm just going to copy them upward just like so, and then extend them back. So why did I do this? Well, once I do this, I can now select the ones on the bottom and change the maximum spacing from 300 to 150. So it's going to have a lot of them on the bottom. So now when we go to the 3D view, and let's just change the visibility states here, view as solid. So as you can see now, it's kind of more closer together on the bottom ones, and then it's spread out on top. It's anchored down to the foundation. And there we go. That's how you add a rebar to foundation in Revit. Now, if you want to get this project file, you can find it on my Patreon page. I'm going to include a link to it in the bottom in the description just below this video, and also up in the cards above. You can get this project file as well as all of my other Revit project files. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.